Well, after a decade of negotiations, the Morrison government has signed an historic trade deal with India, reducing our economic dependence on China.
Yeah, the agreement will benefit both farmers and everyday Australians, with the majority of export tariffs scrapped and most of India's imports entering the country duty-free. For more, we're joined by Matthew McCulloch from Langmuir Winery in South Australia. They make a great Shiraz there. Mm. And wool producer Ed Story in Canberra. Matt, let's start with you. This has been a long time coming.
It has been a long time coming, and it's great to get some good news finally after the last few years of complicated times.
And when you say complicated times, I assume we're talking about China's boycott of Australian wine. So, I mean, how much of a hit did you take from that?
Oh, look, the industry took a fairly major hit. It was an export sector with a value of about $1.2 billion annually. And we worked hard over many years to get it up to that stage. So to lose it at a stroke of a pen was pretty tough. Mm. And then coupled with 2 years of a pandemic has made it a pretty complicated time.
So this deal with China then, it's a phased reduction in regards to tariffs with wine. How much is that going to help, you reckon?
It will definitely help. India's a pretty high tariff market at the moment. So there are two tariff reductions depending on the export value of the product. So Australian wines at $7 and above will reduce from 150% to 100%. Then with that phased 5% over 10 years. And for wines over $20 export value, that reduces from 150 to 75%. However, there are still state-based taxes within India, and there are up to 36 different states. So it's going to be complicated, but it's still good news.
And a lot of consumers over there. Ed, there's been a lot of talk about jobs being created. We know that India buys a lot of wool for Australia. What are you predicting in terms of employment on our shore?
Oh, look, hard to tell, Charles, but what it will provide is more certainty for both our wool exporters and the wool importers into India. India is one of the third biggest single importing countries of our wool. As Matthew said, there are some in-state tariffs in India, but there's a tariff that can be applied up to 25% for raw wool into India. So that, when this agreement comes into force, that will disappear, and that's very welcome news, providing more certainty for a significant buyer of Australian wool.
Just how big of a deal is this for your industry, Ed?
Well, it'll provide a lot of certainty. The tariff is currently for export wool at 2.5%, but it can be applied up to 25%. And the tariff for wool tops is at 40%, and it's reducing over time like the wine one. It'll provide a country that takes a large amount of wool from Australia with more certainty to invest and buy our apparel wool. It doesn't compete with Indian domestic production. The Indian apparel sector is a very large employer and a very large exporter in India, so it'll provide more access at a more competitive price for our wool growers into India.
Much like our wine, Ed, our wool has a great reputation, and that's really one of the big selling points. Does that reputation stretch to India, and can you take advantage of that when it comes to all these new consumers?
Look, it does. Our wool has a wonderful reputation, both in its quality terms and its sustainability attributes. We know that's key on consumers' minds at the moment. And we really think it's a biodegradable product. It's a natural fibre. It's going to have a wonderful future. And we know for agricultural exports in Australia, market access is very, very important. This improves our market access into India and will, over time, make a material difference. Mm. So we'd like to congratulate the government, but particularly Minister Tehan, for the hard work that's gone into finally coming to fruition on this free trade deal.
Yeah, it's not easy getting a trade deal with India, as other countries have seen. But look, Matt, this isn't going to be signed off or finalised until after the election. You confident that whoever wins the election and forms government will give this the tick?
Oh, you got to hope so. There aren't many markets around the world the size and scale of India with the opportunity. The market's due to grow from 29 million litres to 56 million litres in the next 5 years. So it's a huge opportunity for Australian winemakers who make quality wines.
There are a few industries being left out, dairy, beef, chickpea producers. This would be a big help for them as well. Do you know any farmers that have been upset by this, Ed, and what can you say to them, or what are they saying to you, more the point, about where this leaves them?
Look, Charles, we're very pleased wool is front and centre of this agreement. We understand it's not for every commodity that Australia ever exports, but trade deals are incremental. We know these things will be developed over time. Different countries have different priorities with respect to the trade deals that have been done now and in the past, and in some other trade deals, other products have got better deals than different commodities. That's sort of how it rolls. We're just very appreciative and pleased that the wool industry has been considered and the vital role we play in Australian life and the value and relationships we have with India. It should be beneficial for our production sector and their textile and processing sector.
It's a foot in the door or a foot in the billion doors, which is a big difference. Gentlemen, we thank you for your time this morning.
Thanks, guys.